For this final segment of Community Focus presented by the Friends of MCTV, we welcome Elly Maxwell, the Dow Gardens entomologist, who will invite us to enjoy butterflies in bloom. Welcome to Community Focus. Elly, Dow Gardens has presented butterflies in bloom each spring for several years. When will the butterflies be accepting visitors this year?
This year it opens on Friday, March the 1st, and runs through April 21st, Easter Sunday.
And that is, so that's every day of the week, 7 days a week during that period?
It is.
And it's from what time to what time?
So 10 in the morning till 4 p.m., but Wednesdays after the time change, March 13th, mm-hmm. we are open till 7:30.
So 7:30 in the evening on Wednesdays then.
Right.
And where are the butterflies housed when they're here in Midland?
Yeah, so we welcome them to the conservatory on Dow Gardens. It is a short walk back.
You have admission for the butterflies in bloom, or is that included with the Dow Gardens pass?
It's included with the pass. So the admission to the gardens is $10 for the daily pass, mm-hmm. $20 for the annual pass. We welcome students for $2, and five and under are free.
Now, what's the best time to visit the conservatory to visit with the butterflies?
So the most important thing about the best time this year is your time. We're encouraging visitors to reserve their spot with a time ticket so they can go right on the website, punch in their annual admission card number, mm-hmm. and reserve a spot. It is really nice to come on those Wednesday late nights though.
So because of limited space in the conservancy, you've instituted a new reservation program.
There is a reservation program.
But people can still walk in, and if there's room, they can...
Yep, there will be a limited number of available
spots. Will there be any new species this year?
Yes, I'm glad you asked. So this year we added a new supplier from Ecuador. So we're getting new species from Ecuador, and we already have three in there. We get 4,000 individual butterflies over the course, and in one day last week we got 406, so it's already rolling.
And those are Ecuador and thus a South American species.
Right.
Have you had South American species before?
No, we've had Costa Rica, so Central America, mm-hmm. but this continent is new.
And are all of these species you have there exotics, non-native, or do you have some native also?
Yeah, so we still get the native species from Florida and Alabama.
Mm-hmm. And visitors, are they allowed to take photographs of the butterflies?
Sure are. We encourage it.
Now, when someone walks into the conservatory, the butterflies will be flying, they'll be resting, they'll be re-emerging from the chrysalis, all
Correct.
Of those things?
Yes, yep. So it's free-flying butterflies. It's like being in the rainforest.
What other activities and events will be offered relating to the butterflies?
Yeah, so on the weekends, our barn that's used for classes during the week, mm-hmm. it converts to a craft area. We also invite Tim Dreyer to visit on Saturday, March 16th. He'll be here 11 to 4 in the barn area. He does a live glass blowing demonstration. He makes butterflies.
I see. Now, on the Saturdays and Sundays in the butterfly craft barn, what kind of activities or crafts will be there?
So we're really excited at Dow Gardens. We're doing an origami display this summer, mm-hmm. and in preparation for that, we've been having fun with origami. So the butterfly theme, you'll see it on the back of my t-shirt, has an origami butterfly and how to fold an origami butterfly. In addition, we've done puppets and coloring pages and simple crafts.
Now, does the Dow Gardens Pass allow cardholders access to Whiting Forest and their new canopy walk?
It does, yep.
So tell us again, Elly, when the butterflies are in bloom.
So they're blooming from Friday, March 1st through April 21st, 10 to 4 daily, 7:30 on Wednesdays after the time change.
Well, Elly, thank you for joining us and telling us about the butterflies and blooms at Dow Gardens.
Thank you.
We're glad that you joined us for the March installment of Community Focus. We've learned about some useful, informative, and educational activities that we can all look forward to in Midland in the coming weeks. The Community Focus program is just one of the activities of the Friends of MCTV, activities that continually support and promote our local cable access television station. If you'd like to join Friends of MCTV or learn more about our organization, you can like us on Facebook, email us at friendsofmctv@gmail.com, or call or visit the MCTV studio in the Grace A. Dow Memorial Library. And remember, if your club or nonprofit organization would like to join us at this table in the months to come, you can find our application online at MCTV's section of the city website, or you can visit MCTV in person to submit an application. We'd love to have you be a part of Community Focus.